Hello and welcome to this week's Choosing Happy podcast. I'm your host, Heather Masters, and today we're diving into a fascinating topic that might just change the way you view your own potential. It's August, 1st of August, and that means it's Woo Month here on the show. So join me today to find out more about the woo, how it can help with you choosing happiness. Hello and welcome to the Choosing Happy podcast. Today's show is all about the woo, because it's Woo Month here on the Choosing Happy podcast. So what is the woo? The woo is often thought to be short for woo-woo, which refers to ideas or practices considered unconventional or based on unproven beliefs. This includes areas like psychic abilities, energy healing, intuitive practices. And while some may dismiss these concepts, many people find them to be powerful tools for personal growth and self-discovery, me included. And if you look at the work by Joe Dispenza and Bruce Lipton, you find that science is very much backing up our ability to manifest, to create, and to affect the field. So why explore your woo side? It expands your perspective. It's good fun. It gets you to open yourself up to new ideas that can really broaden your worldwide view and your life on a daily basis. And that in itself leads to personal growth and the ability to change your definition of what you think of as real, and in recognizing how much you impact your reality, you can, in fact, change your world and change your life. Tapping into intuition is massively important. When I think back through my life, I know that the biggest mistakes I made were when I ignored my intuition. And sometimes it's been things simple as getting stuck in traffic and starting to get annoyed, but then realizing that there's a purpose, that I was delayed. And then a few minutes later, turning up to see a huge crash at a roundabout or something like that, that, you know, you can kind of tune in and see that someone up there or in the field is protecting you and wanting you to be safe. So tapping into your intuition can not only be brilliant for creativity, brilliant for business growth, you know, that gut feeling that business owners rely on to really make good decisions. It's also about enhancing decision-making, self-awareness, and as I say, your manifesting ability as well as keeping you safe in the world. In terms of decision-making, one of the little known facts is that we all make decisions based on emotion. If you track your decision-making techniques, we tend to make a decision very quickly and then go to logic to back it up. And you can check the science on that as well. Number three, in terms of why explore your woo side, is the stress relief. Practices that are considered woo, like meditation and mindfulness and energy work, can help reduce stress and promote relaxation. But in addition to that, if you're working with energy, you can actually tap into the field and restore the energy in your body. So if you're feeling down, once you become aware, there are many techniques for waking yourself up. Obviously, movement is a really simple one, but grounding yourself, you know, there's the scientific backed evidence about grounding and how it changes the electrons and the whole field within your body to give you that extra energy and even increase and boost your immune system. For personal empowerment, Exploring these areas of the woo may help you discover some hidden talents or strengths you didn't know you had. And in addition to that, it's really about tapping into the source of who you are. And there's nothing more empowering than recognizing who you truly are and coming from a space that, once you tap into it, becomes difficult to move you out of. So you become a little bit Teflon if you really do tap in and practice these techniques and understand that you're always looked after. And when you follow your intuition and your guidance, then you know nothing really can disturb you. So opening up to your intuitive and woo side can significantly increase your happiness because you're fostering that deeper connection with yourself. You're enhancing your decision-making and promoting your overall well-being. You're enhancing your self-connection. And that's because increased self-awareness through practicing some of these techniques really helps you to tap into your intuition and become more attuned to your inner thoughts and feelings. And becoming more attuned, especially to your feelings and emotions within the body, can heighten your self-awareness and lead to a better understanding of your own needs and desires, rather than looking outside for guidance on these. And it's crucial for personal fulfillment that we take ownership of our true needs and desires and our reason for being here, our purpose, if you like. Enhanced self-connection helps with emotional regulation. Again, practices like mindfulness and meditation, which are often associated with intuitive development, they can calm the mind and reduce anxiety. And in addition to that, if you look into somatic practices, they can really help releasing any trapped trauma. A quieter mind is more receptive to intuitive insights, which can guide you towards decisions that align with your true self, with what you truly love, what you truly want from life, thereby enhancing your emotional well-being. And as I said, you can become kind of a Teflon person, because once you're really tuned in to that inner compass, it's difficult to move you off there from the outside. So how does a better decision-making work? As I mentioned earlier, it's about trusting your gut, and intuition is a powerful tool for making decisions that feel right on a deeper level. And when you trust your gut feelings, you're more likely to make choices that are in harmony with your values and long-term happiness. And it's really about knowing what to do in the moment as well. Steve Jobs and Einstein both emphasized the importance of intuition in their decision-making processes, highlighting its role in achieving success and satisfaction. And from my own personal experience, I think it's really difficult to feel guilt or remorse if you've actually followed your intuition, because your intuition, as I just said, is really what's in alignment with your own values and with yourself in that moment. So you're avoiding regret by listening to your intuitive voice. You're less likely to make that decision that will lead to regret or dissatisfaction, because intuition helps you recognize what truly matters to you and guides you away from choices that might seem logical, but are not fulfilling or not even in integrity with who you are. In terms of promoting well-being, we've already mentioned the stress reduction. Engaging in intuitive practices like meditation and mindfulness significantly reduce stress. They significantly reduce anxiety as well. The purpose is to keep you as much as possible in the moment so that you're operating from the now, the powerful now place. And also, these practices help clear mental clutter, and that makes it easier for you to hear your inner voice and feel more at peace in general. It enhances your positive mental state as well. Regularly tuning into your intuition can lead to a more positive mental state when you make decisions that align with your true self. Your experience of self, a sense of self-empowerment and control over your life, which are key components of happiness. So here are some practical steps to enhance your intuition. There's mindfulness and meditation, which we've mentioned. Even spending a few minutes each day in quiet reflection or meditation can make a big difference, especially if you can do a few minutes a day, a few times a day. It really, really helps you in coming back to center and tuning in to that inner voice. It helps calm the mind and it makes it easier for you to tune in to your guidance and make better decisions. You can try journaling, keeping a journal to record your intuitive insights and dreams. Writing down your thoughts can help you recognize patterns and validate your intuitive experiences. It's really useful for that because if you are keeping a journal, you've got something to go back to when you kind of have that aha moment and know that you've had an intuitive hit about something. Nature walks really help to enhance intuition because you're spending time in nature to clear your mind and you connect with your surroundings, you connect with nature, and it can enhance your ability to receive and trust your internal messages and your gut feelings. You can try playing intuitive games. I know I did this many, many moons ago when I was really testing my intuition and psychic ability, if you like. I engaged in activities that really got me to use my intuition, such as standing on the corner of a major road and guessing how many cars were going to come around and what colour of the first car would be. Also, if you're on a train, guessing how many passengers are going to get off and how many passengers are going to get on at the next station. So you can kind of play different games and it's all good fun and it builds that intuitive muscle. And, you know, the simple one is guessing who's calling when your phone rings and just trying to tune in to see who it is and making a note of the outcome. So by incorporating these practices into your daily life, you can enhance your intuitive abilities. And it can really help with your happiness and a more fulfilling life because you're focusing on the positive stuff as well. You're focusing on what you want to happen. And also, one thing that I've really found beneficial is trusting that everything is happening for me. The universe is working with me. Here's a weekly challenge because it is, as I say, it's August, it's woo-woo month. So I'm going to have a weekly challenge each week throughout August. And today's is to start a dream journal. So we put a journal and a pen by your bed on a night. And if you wake up during the night because you've had a vivid dream, take a moment to note it down. And you can share the experiences if you'd like to, either in the Facebook page for Choosing Happy Podcast, or if you want to in the comments on the podcast as well. You can, and I'll see if there's anything to share in the next episode. And next episode, we'll have another weekly challenge, just something to get you engaged and to get you enjoying this woo month. So what to expect for the rest of the month? I'll be interviewing a diverse range of psychics, healers, and energy workers, and business owners who use the woo or use energy or use alignment with their higher selves to get absolutely amazing results in their business. These experts will share their insights, their experiences, their own stories, plus practical tips to help you explore your own intuitive and energy gifts. Here are some action steps if you want to add, in addition to the challenge, so that you increase your own intuition over the next few weeks. Each day, take a moment to ask yourself a question and then listen to your first instinctive response. Write it down and see how accurate it is over time. Energy check-ins. Before bed, scan your body from head to toe and notice any areas of tension or unusual sensations. And that's just really for you to tune into your body, increase your body awareness. and potentially your energy sensitivity. When you're out on walks, it's holiday season, so if you're walking in nature, focus on your senses, what you feel, hear, or smell that you might normally overlook. One way I do this is I think of three things that I can see, I identify three things I can feel externally, three things I feel internally in terms of emotions and breathing, and if my tummy's gurgling, I tune into three different sounds. And as I say, it's really about helping you to attune into subtle energies around you as well. Share your experiences, or if you have any questions, you can either email me or put them on any of the social media platforms using the hashtag ChoosingHappyWoo. I'd love to hear about your journey into the world of woo this month. And remember, exploring these areas is about personal growth and self-discovery, as well as releasing stress and choosing happy. There's no need to believe everything you hear. Approach it with an open mind and see what resonates with you. It's one of the things that I've really found on my journey throughout intuitive practices and spiritual practices, is really finding what works for you. There's so much out there. You know, be mindful and choose what resonates. So stay tuned for our upcoming episodes in August, where we'll delve deeper into various woo practices and how they might enhance your life and your business and your finances. So until next time, keep choosing happy and stay curious about the mysteries of life. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to this week's episode. If you enjoyed it or think it would be valuable to others, please do share. And if you really enjoyed it, please leave me a review. It really helps the podcast. All of the links are in the show notes. And I look forward to seeing you next week on the Choosing Happy podcast.